between the Miami Marlins and the East-leading Philadelphia Phillies. Hi again, folks. Matt Vasgersian here to bring you this matchup of NL Eastern Division rivals. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, a good matchup on the mound here in this opener.
Well, I think we're going to see a couple of pitchers here that have had similar struggles so far this season. Both of them under 500, neither really having the season that they were expecting when they came out of spring training. So we'll see if they can turn things around here.
Christian Yelich. The move towards the batter's box as we're just about set to get underway tonight. First of three here on a Friday night as the first pitch is in there for strike one. DK, let's take a look at our homestanding nine as they enter play here this evening. They enter this one off a loss after winning 5 of 7 prior to that.
And I think it's just going to be a matter of putting yesterday behind you. It wasn't their finest performance of the year, that's for sure, but they're capable of playing much better ball, and I think we'll see a sharper focus here in this one.
Goes the other way as this is lined to left, but he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is called in for the first down. With that, why don't we check out the scouting report for tonight's starter. As you see, the pitches he'll rely on as the night moves forward. Martin Prado will stand in as he'll enter play fourth in the National League batting race. Now a check swing, but it's strike one anyway, says the home plate umpire. Check swing, but he held up in time, ball one.
And you'd be in trouble at the plate if you fell behind 0-2 against this guy, so he's fortunate to hold up in time.
And they'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. Giancarlo Stanton will stand in now. Certainly a dangerous hitter as he ranks number two in the National League in home runs. And this one runs up high, ball one. Got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings. Meanwhile, now this is a drive out to straightaway right field, and it's gonna get out of here, a home run. A solo home run here off the bat of Giancarlo Stanton. 24 home runs for him on the season as the Marlins will take a 1-0 lead.
Well, not much of a surprise here. This is what MVPs do. He's fortunate here that they decide to come after him. I don't know why, but that is a fundamentally strong swing. The ball just jumps off his bat. It's way out of here with plenty to spare.
Marcell Ozuna will stand in now, and obviously one to be careful with, as you see there, currently leading the senior circuit in long balls. Too low, 1-0.
Yeah, those are the ones you like to start in that bat, especially your first time up.
I agree. Give me a nice, easy one in the dirt that I can take so I can really get ahead in that count early.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Toward the gap in right center, this is going to be a base hit, and he may take that big turn at first. And he'll round it and try for third. The relay, but he is in there with a triple. Jeff Baker will get his first shot here, trying to come through with two away and a runner at third. Now here's the first pitch. Down and away, one ball and no strikes. One oh. And this one's on the inside corner, 1-1.
Yeah, I don't think you want to come in throwing a lot of high changeups. That's a pitch he's going to have to get lower in the strike zone.
He will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Marlins are on the board first thanks to the solo home run. Bottom of the first coming up, Miami out to an early 1-0 lead. Ben Revere will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first. Here's a fastball up that he sends in the air out to fairly deep center field. There to handle it is Ozuna, and there's one away. away here with the bases empty, and making his way in is the second baseman, Chase Utley. And this will be lined into center field, and they've got themselves their first hit of the ball game. Brandon Jordan will stand in, currently eighth in the National League in hitting to enter play. First pitch on the way. Oh, it's hit to third. 5-4-3, but it's not in time, and the inning will continue.
Well, you could have put the first base bag out in the outfield grass on this play. You're not going to double this guy up. He's too fast. Still, a pretty good job of at least getting that lead runner at second base.
Michael Franco will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. First pitch coming. He's running towards second. Now a swing and a little tapper to the left of the mound. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. Phillies down on just four pitches. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Michael Morse leads things off now in the top half of the second.
Michael Morse.
Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0. The pitch. Swing and a miss, 1-1.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch. And they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
Swing and a high chopper. Knee high, he barehands it. And now, oh, this ball's going to wind up out of play. And a big mistake there.
Boy, nowhere close with this throw. Here's another look at first base. I mean, not only is this thing over his head, but you see it take off to the right field side of the bag, so it's not even on target. Very sloppy there. Potentially dangerous, too.
Off the plate again. 2-0 now.
And this is what you got to do up there, Steve. You got to wait him out.
Yeah, and if you can lay off the off-speed stuff, that's when you're going to get your fastball to hit.
Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. Late swing, but he's still able to get a lot of this one out toward deep right field. And that is off the wall in right field.
Well, these guys have one home run already, and this was nearly a second one here. You can see it bang off the wall out there on the fly, and he's going to wind up with a double. But he didn't miss a big fly by much.
The catcher, Jared Saltalamacchia, is in now as he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. He comes in with that average down in the 240s. Four home runs, 26 RBIs. 1-0 pitch is a circle change, swung on and missed, 1-1. Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
As you can see right here, his timing just seems to be off a little bit at the plate right now. And you know what? That can happen during the course of the season. You're not always going to have your good swing. And he's the kind of guy that's got a lot of moving parts in that swing. So maybe he's at the point now in the season where he might need just a little time off so he can get back to the basics.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Now with two strikes? Boy, if he could come up with back-to-back punch-outs, wouldn't that be something?
And he struck him out.
Well, even though it's just the second inning, you sure don't want to get in the habit of leaving runners in scoring position. So now this next at-bat is going to be a pretty telling one early on.
Christian Yelich will try it once more. He lined out to start the ball game. And a ball, 1-0. Has a look, now the pitch. And the off-speed pitch is taken here, a ball and a strike.
Boy, and if these guys come away with nothing here, we'll have squandered a real good opportunity.
Here's Lee with the 2-1. Now a fastball here as this is slashed the other way over the third baseman's head. A fair ball. One run scores. The throw to the plate. And he will score as well. And they've pushed the lead up to 3-0 now.
Well, this is a spot where you're asking your leadoff hitter to be an RBI guy. And he does the job here, driving home two on the RBI single.
Martin Prado will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
And now this is all about minimizing damage out there on the mound. He's got to regroup.
And sorry to interrupt, but the play has been made for the third out. Inning over. So two runs on two hits, one error, and one man left on base. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. It's the Marlins 3 and the Phillies nothing. Adrian Beltre will start things off in the bottom of the second. First offering on the way. On the ground is short. And the throw to first is in time, one gone.
Well, and that's exactly what you want to do right there. Get yourself another ground ball, and that's a good way to start the second as he gets the easy ground out.
Now the first pitch. Outside with the fastball, that's 1-0. This Marlin ball club, Eric Karros, as they begin play here tonight, they've been in a serious tailspin of late, winning just once in their previous 10 games.
Yeah, they still find themselves stuck in third place in the division, but this is an important stretch for these guys, and if they can string a few victories together, they've got a chance to get back into it.
And that is going to be a base hit.
And this is something they've worked on in the batting cages, taking some of the movement out of his swing. Much more compact now, and he's seeing some definite results.
First pitch coming. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right, but he'll barely have to move out there in right as he hauls this one in for the second out. Ryan Howard will stand in now, still struggling to get anything going offensively. Here's the first pitch to him. Oh, missed that one by a mile. It's 0-1. Think he'll see another one of those before this at-bat's through?
After that swing, I think you can just about take that to the bank.
And a bouncing ball, foul. From the stretch. Hit hard but foul toward first, so he'll come back and line it up again. The next 0-2. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. But he will make the catch on the dead run as he tracks it down just shy of the wall, and the side is retired. One left for Philadelphia. They trail in this one 3-0. Giancarlo Stanton is ready to go here as we begin the third.
Right fielder, Giancarlo Stanton.
Now here's the first pitch. Now a fastball to start the third. That misses. It's ball one. Here it comes. Had him out in front there as he takes strike one on the circle change. Here's the pitch. Oh, he pulls the string on the circle change, 1-2. Now a swing and a miss, and Stanton is down on strikes for round number one. Marcell Ozuna will dig in, a triple in his first plate appearance of the ballgame. And he lays off there, 1-0. That pitch count, as you see, already standing at 41.
And you don't need Eric or I to tell you about that. That's way too many this early.
Now Lee Reddy's the 2-0. 3-0 now.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
The 3-0 pitch. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. Now he lifts a high pop-up. Drifting into foul territory on the right side. And the first baseman can't get there. Here's the full count offering. Now a check swing here and a little looper. And this is taken in by Beltre for the second out.
Yeah, you can see he tried to hold back, but he'd gone too far already, so this becomes a simple little pop-out.
Stepping in now, Jeff Baker. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. 1-0 on the way. 2-0.
Well, this is a guy up there that's not hitting a ton right now, but he can still work the count. And that alone can be beneficial to an offense.
I think he would have liked the green light there. It's 2-1. Still no fastballs in the at bat. It's been all off speed.
That's definitely by design. He's such a good.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. But they lead it 3-0. Cliff Lee makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number 3. First pitch of the inning here is wrapped right back from where it came, and that'll get into center field for a leadoff single. Ben Revere will try it again. He flied out to start the home first. And here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss as he was way in front of that one.
You know, it's so important with guys like this to get ahead with strike one. Put them behind in the count and on their back foot right away.
And he starts to go after it. Question was, did he hold up in time? Yes, indeed, says the third base umpire. The 1-1 home. This ball's grounded foul. One, two. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time.
He just about went around. He was lucky to put on the brakes when he did.
2-2. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
We saw this in his last start. He just hasn't been able to find that put away pitch with two strikes that you gotta have at this level.
To the right side, but foul, and he'll try it again. Payoff pitch one more time. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four.
Yeah, that's nice to see a little patience up there. These guys have been what I would call overly aggressive these first few innings. Finally, somebody's figured out the importance of maybe taking a pitch or two.
Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. Echevarria for one. The relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step.
Yeah, that's good hustle getting down the line. A double play could have really put the brakes on this rally, but he's able to beat it out on the back end just to keep things going here.
Now the first pitch. And this one gets away. That could be a run. And it is a run.
You know, there's no wrong way to get on the scoreboard for the first time. That's a great job at third of recognizing the situation. He takes off immediately, and he'll come in and score on the wild pitch.
The 1-0. Now a swing, and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time.
That ball was so deep in his kitchen, that was the only thing he could do was foul it off, break his bat, and hope to get a better pitch on the next one.
Here comes the 1-1. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground towards short. Throw gets him, two down. Michael Franco will stand in. He grounded out his first time. First pitch to him. And a fastball to start things out here. Not close, it's a ball and no strikes. 1-0 pitch now, and he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Well, with every pitch it misses, he just keeps digging himself a deeper and deeper hole.
Swing, hard hit ball to second. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. I have to imagine there's a full moon tonight, judging by this bunch. More in a moment on the show, the Friday Night Showcase. Michael Morse will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
Michael Morse.
And Lee will open the at-bat with a good changeup there for strike one. Lee ready with the 0-1. Line down the left field line. But this is foul near the seats. The 0-2 now from Lee. Now here's a ground ball that'll get by the mound and into center field for a leadoff single.
The batter number three,
Adani Echevarria, will stand in. He doubled and later scored his first time. And a ball popped foul to the right side, out of play. Pause, now the pitch. Now the 0-1 is swung on and lifted out to straightaway center field. Revere will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first.
Boy, these are the kind of days where even I want to grab a bat. Everybody in that offense is hitting the ball hard somewhere.
Jared Saltalamacchia is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball that's 1-0. That's wide, 2-0.
I think he's going out there right now just to remind his guy, hey, this is the number 8 hitter up there. No reason to work the edges. You just come right after him.
And that is through into left field, a base hit.
A little bad luck there defensively. If that's hit at an infielder, it's a double play. But instead, now you're in hot water here with one away.
In now, Carlos Carrasco showing bunt here, but he takes ball one.
And you know, I've always thought if you're pretty sure a guy might be trying to bunt, then put that first pitch out of the strike zone. Make him show you his intentions. Maybe you get him to offer something that he shouldn't.
Bunt attempt is popped into foul ground. The 1-1 from Lee. Got it back in time there, and it's 2-1.
And that curveball is normally one of his best pitches. He just hasn't had a great feel for it so far.
He waits. Now the pitch. Trying to give himself up here, but this is foul, so the runners will return. The 2-2 now from Lee. And now a two-strike bunt attempt here as this one's down. And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works to perfection.
Yeah, and how about that? The bunt stays on here with two strikes. Remember, if this is foul, he's out via the strikeout. But fortunately for him, he's able to lay this one down and get the job done.
Christian Yelich is at the plate as he watches ball one. The 1-0 home. Here's the swing and a chance for Howard over at first. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Marlins strand a pair, and it's still 3-1. Adrian Beltre will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. Here's the first offering. Chopper foul. And now a pitch on the way. Hard hit to third. Oh, and he overshoots his first baseman as it's over his head. And now, oh, this ball's going to wind up out of play. And a big mistake there.
Well, everything looked okay here on the pickup and transfer. But then you see him just fire this thing straight into the box seats down there. That's going to be scored an E5 and a lucky souvenir baseball for one of the fans.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as this is grounded foul off to the left at strike one. He's set, now the pitch. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. Morse is over and he's got it for the first out of the inning. Dominic Brown will stand in, a lineout victim his first time. Here's the first offering. Now a ball sliced out of play down the left field line. 3-1 is our score here in inning number four. Comes set, now the pitch. That's taken, now it's 0-2. Surprised at all that they're coming right after him this way?
A little bit. I like it, it's good for the game, but this is definitely a guy that can hurt you if you're not careful.
but right to the second baseman, and that's the second out. Two are gone in the Philly fourth, and digging in, slugging first baseman Ryan Howard. Now here's the first pitch. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. No shot there for Morse. It's down the line. A fair ball. Long throw to the plate. And the run will score from second as they cut it to one at 3-2 now.
That two-out hit there makes that error move extra large now. You've got to make sure you get this next guy before this inning gets any further out of control.
Cliff Lee will try and keep things going now with the runner at first following the RBI single. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
Now you've got the tying run over at first, two away. He's going to be looking to try and find a gap right here and bring that guy all the way around to score.
Oh, got him to swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two.
Well, as we've seen so far, this isn't a team that's going to wait around too long to feel a pitcher out. They're an aggressive team all the way from top to bottom. And if that first pitch is anywhere close, most of these guys are going to take a hack at it.
The 1-2. And a bouncing ball, foul. He'll try again, 1-2. And this is fouled back and out of play. Another 1-2 delivery. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land foul just shy of the wall. Now another 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Two runs, four hits, and one error in the ballgame for the Phillies so far. The 2-2 one more time. Gets under this one as this is hit high and pretty deep out there to center field. Ozuna is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. So it's one run on one hit, one error in the inning, and a runner left. Martin Prado will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ballgame. Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. Hits ball one. Now the pitch. Swung on and missed on a pitch at the thumbs, a ball and a strike.
Yeah, and it seems like he kind of got away from that pitch here in the last few innings. You got to think about bringing that one right back.
And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field. And this is going to be extra bases here to kick off the fifth. Around second now, and this ball still hasn't been fielded. And he's going for it all, headed for the plate. And a relay home, and he will score on the inside the park home run, and that was a gift right there.
Something you don't see all that often, and it's still one of the most exciting plays in all of the game as far as I'm concerned. I was thinking that he might get held up at third, but he was having none of that. He had that inside the park home run on his mind from the get-go, and sure enough, he winds up getting it all.
Giancarlo Stanton now. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Base is empty here with nobody out. Pitch on the way. Hammered the other way to deep right field. But he's going to haul this one in on the run as he winds up just shy of the wall for the first down. Marcell Ozuna is in for the third time as he looks at a ball high. It's 1-0.
And even though he's given up his share of hits so far, he still hasn't walked anybody, so at least he's got that going for him.
Four runs, seven hits, and one error so far for the Marlins. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Ah, that thing's knee high on the outside third of the plate. Pretty understandable why he couldn't catch up with that one.
And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
Well, this pitch looked to be up. We'll get a look at it on pitch track. Yep, you'll see it there. That thing's well above the letters. You're just playing right into the pitcher's hand when you chase a ball that high.
Into the box now, Jeff Baker. As he takes it, it's 0-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. 0-1 is a circle change that's over for a called strike.
And this has been a pretty good comeback from that leadoff home run. Two straight outs now and two strikes here as well.
Tried a change of pace with two strikes there, but it misses 1-2.
Tough pitch to lay off there with two strikes. I'm not sure if that was a good take or whether he just got fooled on a changeup and couldn't pull the trigger.
And did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike three. So one run on one base hit, the home run, no errors, and no one left. Ben Revere will lead it off here for Philadelphia, to be followed on deck by Chase Utley. And this ball's pulled on the ground down the line to first. And he'll take this to the bag, three unassisted for the first out.
The amazing thing is that he's still yet to strike a guy out so far. But when you've got good movement on your off-speed stuff, you don't have to strike guys out to be successful.
Chase Utley is in for the third time as he swings and misses at that one. It's nothing and one. Now the pitch. Here's a swing and a ground ball, but this will wind up a foul ball, strike two. Now here's the pitch.
Here we go.
Smack the opposite way now, and this should give him at least two bases. Utley now will hit for second. And he'll cruise into the bag at second with a one-out double. So a double into the gap has him in business here with one away. And as our graphic will illustrate, in terms of team rankings, he's currently second best on this Philly ball club in that department. Brandon Jordan will stride in, grounded out his last time through. First pitch on the way. And now a slider in on the hands, and he's lucky that one didn't come and get him. For Utley, a good job there to pick up his 16th double of the year. The 1-0. Lined hard to center field. And he won't get it as that's down for a base hit. Mike Franco will stand in again. A couple of ground outs for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. First pitch coming. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score.
Well, this is going to get him a run closer. A simple ground ball here plates the runner from third, and we're back now to a one-run game.
Adrian Beltre will look to try and get that second run of the inning across as he'll have a runner at third now with two away. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance. Out of here. She was a wall scraper, but it counts just the same. A home run. So it's a two-run homer for Adrian Beltre. Number 10 for him on the year. As they will take the lead here, it's now a 5-4 ball game.
Sometimes these pitchers, they let their egos get the better of them. But here, instead of working the corners, maybe using something with a little more movement, gives them a straight challenge. Winds up costing.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. As he gets under the first pitch and sends a fly ball out to a right field. Stanton is under this one as he tucks this one away to retire the side. They strike for three in the inning, two on this two-run home run. We're through five innings here tonight. Philadelphia's out in front now, 5-4. Michael Morse will stand in to lead things off as the Marlins look to get things started here in their half of the sixth. first offering to him stays upstairs, it's a ball and no strikes.
Yeah, that's a good spot to miss against a guy like this. He loves that pitch up in the zone. Most power hitters do, so that's not a bad idea to give him one above the letters.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Down by a run, your guys need you on base any way you can get there. Now you got to shrink that strike zone down and not go after anything that's not right there for you.
Checks his swing, but this pitch is right there for strike one. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth. Adani Echevarria will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Now he takes something off there as this is skied out to deep center field. And this is hauled in on the run for the out. And he had a lot of ground to cover to get to that one. Jared Saltalamacchia will stand in. The strikeout victim his first time and then a base hit last time around. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit.
Now after the big inning your ball club just put together, you can't let them respond with a big inning of their own. But here they are with two on now and trying to answer right back.
Here's a 1-0. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And the throw will go to second as they get the force out. But wisely, no thought of a return throw, and the inning will continue. Christian Yelich will step in now and see what he can do with two on and two out here in the sixth. Good changeup there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one. Sliced hard down the left field line. And this is going to wind up as extra bases as that'll play one for sure and maybe a second. Third baseman Martin Prado will get another crack, one for three thus far. Now some action in the Phillies bullpen as a right-hander begins to crank it up out there. And there's a fastball from Lee to start him out. It's 0-1. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. Marlins forced to settle for one. Bottom part of the order, 7, 8, and 9 due up in the home half. And we are all tied 5-5. Brian Morris will come on now as he'll start out the bottom of the sixth. Dominic Brown will start things out for the Phillies with the dangerous Ryan Howard waiting on deck. Dominic Brown. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. This is foul for the first strike. Now here it comes. Oh, and this at-bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now.
That thing's coming in there hot, 96 miles an hour.
Here it comes. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Yeah, with the bases empty, that's the right spot for that 0-2 pitch. Make him see if he'll chase that slider.
Here comes a 1-2. Now a swing by Brown as this ball is drilled out to deep right field. But that'll be off the right field wall.
It's kind of a surprise to me that he wouldn't try to go for two on this play. I don't know if he got caught up in his home run trot a little bit too early or what. He's going to wind up on first base here with a single off the wall.
First offering on the way. Ryan Howard stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1.
Yeah, and that's the swing of a guy hoping for a first pitch curveball right there. If he gets it, he hammers it. If not, he's about 3 feet too late.
Go, Ryan. He's set. Now the pitch. And this one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike.
Get that running at second base.
Ready now on 1-1. And this is going to be a foul ball. Here's the 1-2. Oh, and he just carves him up there on four pitches. One gone. Xavier Paul has moved into the on-deck circle now, so that means the end for Cliff Lee. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. Echevarria for one. On to the pitcher covering, and it's in time. A double play, and the inning is over. One hit's all they get. Seventh inning coming up, and we are all tied 5-5. Giancarlo Stanton will stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. And here you go, a solo home run that had him off and running early. Giancarlo Stanton will try it again. He homered back in the first inning of this one. And a high strike there, 0-1.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. And that's plenty hard enough to blow by guys when you need to.
On to first, and a big out to start the seventh, one gone. Marcelo Zuna will dig in. Strikeout victim his last time. He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
3-0 now.
He knows the drill out there. You gotta make him swing the bat. Cannot be giving up walks at this stage of the game, because those could be fatal.
And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Jeff Baker will try again. 0-3 thus far. And he's no doubt searching for a ground ball here as this sinker dips below the knees. It's 1-0. And that's right there, and we're even at one. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? One there. Relay to Howard, and it's in time. The double play, that ends the inning. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Ben Revere will lead it off here for Philadelphia, to be followed on deck by Chase Utley. Pitch coming. Swing and a hard liner to center field. Ozuna is there, and he has it for the first out.
Well, this ball was hit pretty hard, and he's just hoping to get on base as the go-ahead run. But it kind of hangs up there a little bit too long, and it finds the outfielder's glove.
Now the first pitch, and this will be fouled away. The pitch. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground at first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
As a manager, you love your relievers to come in and give you plenty of strikeouts. But I'll tell you what, there isn't a manager alive that'll get upset when you come in and get two outs on three pitches.
Brandon Jordan will step in. Singleton came around to score his last time. Here's the first pitch to him. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Phillies down on just four pitches. This remains a 5-all ball game. Michael Morse will stand in, and it's a bullpen game now. Both starters out as we begin inning number 8.
Yeah, both starters are out, and since we're tied, both starters not going to be involved in the decision.
And a strike to even the count. 1-1. Sinker is right there for a called strike two. Figure we'll probably see a heavy dose of that sinker here tonight.
It's really a pitch he'll lean on, especially when he needs that ground ball. But even in situations like this where he's just trying to get ahead.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller, the thought is that you've got to get out there and hit the ball before it sinks. So that means if you're a right-handed hitter, you got to jump out there and pull it. And that's exactly what he did.
First pitch is a changeup for a called strike. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. And he takes this one high, 1-1. From the belt, the pitch. Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire, ball two.
You know, sometimes when you're thinking fastball, you try to get moving just a little bit early. That's a good job of recognizing off speed and then holding back on the swing.
Take something off there as this is skied out to deep center field. Revere has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first down. Well, no shortage of runs in this one. Still anyone's game for the tanking in a tie ball game, but let's bring you a look at how our two starters fared. It's our starter comparison. Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. And he gives this one a pretty good ride down the left field line, and that nearly broke our tie, but instead it's a foul ball. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he got him to swing early as this is skied out toward right. And he can't track it down. A base hit. Throw in time as he's called out on a very close play at second.
Oh, my goodness. I'll tell you, if I had a base hit taken away by a runner getting forced out by an outfielder, well, you'd have to put a straitjacket on me because, you know, I didn't get many hits. That's just a really bad read right there and a real waste of a base runner.
Cody Ashe will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 25, Cody Ashe.
Too high, 1-0.
If there's one guy on this roster who wants the ball in a moment like this, this is the guy.
Back to the changeup, but this one finds the target for strike one. That's on the corner to put him behind now. 1-2 from the belt. Kicks and deals. Swing, and he puts a charge into this one. High and deep, and you can't forget about it. This ball is gone. A two-run blast to straightaway right field, and they take a 7-5 lead.
Well, when you start relying on one pitch out there, and you become a one-pitch pitcher, there's no doubt in the hitter's mind what's coming. He's sitting on this one all the way, and he launches it right over the wall.
The left field number 21, Christian Yelich.
Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. In is Christian Yelich. As he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner, it's 0-1. Two out, nobody on. Here's the pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. Now here's the pitch. He makes good contact on it as this is going to make its way through into left field for a base hit. Martin Prado will stand in. He homered back in the fifth inning of this one. First pitch of the at-bat is lifted in the air out to left. Paul is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. But two in the inning for the Marlins thanks to the two-run home run. On now to the bottom of inning number 8. It's the Marlins 7 and the Phillies 5. Donovan Solano will stay in the ballgame as a new shortstop.
Now playing shortstop. Number 17.
Don Kelly will stay in the ball game as he'll take over at first base.
Don Kelly. Your attention, please.
So a new pitcher set to come on. It'll be the 6'4 right-hander Nick Massett that gets the call. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And now the bat explodes as this has popped up. And he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first out.
And now on the mound, this is where you need to get into that mindset of putting these guys away. You're up 2 here on the road, and a nice 1-2-3 inning here could pretty well take this crowd out of the ballgame.
And now the second pitch of the inning is hit in the air to center. Under it is Ozuna, and there are two gone now. Salvador Perez will stand in as they're quickly down to their final 4 outs tonight. First pitch coming. Now a liner caught it, and no, actually. Looked like he had it in his sights, but it got right by.
Maybe
maybe that's the break they needed to get back into this ballgame. Well, no question, they need base runners at this late stage, so they'll take any help they can get.
Damian Trejo is up off the bench with a bat in hand, and that'll spell the end for the pitcher, Williams. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Throw on to first, and that error won't come back to haunt him after all as the inning is over. Phillies down on just four pitches. They're down 7-5. Ken Giles will come on now to start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is for the bottom of the ninth. And this is going to be a foul ball. Pitch on the way. And he pumps the fastball by him at 94. It's 0-2. Now the pitch. And a good pitch there as he reaches out to hit this one on the ground to first. And he'll take this to the bag, three unassisted for the first out. Marcelo Ozuna will stand in, base on balls his last time. Here's a first pitch slider that just tails out of the zone. It's ball one. Just missing here, 2-0.
Boy, I don't know that I'd want to be facing this guy right now. He looks pretty fired up out there.
Yeah, he looks like he could run that fastball through a brick wall.
And a fastball misses there, ball four. Jeff Baker will try and erase his 0-for-4 in the ball game. And a fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. 1-0 pitch is right there, but ruled a ball, 2-0.
Yeah, and he didn't seem to do him any favors with the previous batter. And now, here's another call that goes against him on the mound.
Good slider there. Tough pitch, and from 2-0, it's back to 2-2. He's ready now. The pitch. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? To second for one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. Nothing further in the Miami ninth. One last shot now for Philadelphia. They're on the short end of a 7-5 score. Steve Cishek is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth. Jeff Francoeur will be summoned to pinch hit here to start the bottom of the ninth. And remember, they need 2 to tie, 3 to win, so he's got his work cut out for him here. And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Stanton is there to make the catch, and it's a dreadful start to the bottom of the ninth. One pitch, one out. Xavier Paul will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. Hit hard on the ground to short. And boy, just about overshot his man at first, but he's able to keep a foot on the bag over there, and that's out number two. Ben Revere is the last chance now with two out here in the ninth. Now here's the first pitch. First pitch to him here is hit on the ground to the left side as he doesn't waste any time. That's into left for a base hit.
Now having the second baseman.
Chase Utley will dig in now, and he'll do so representing the tying run.
Yeah, and you're not too worried about this guy jumping the yard on you here and tying the ball game. But if he does find a way to get on base, things get a whole lot more interesting.
Now the first pitch. Pulls this one high and deep to right center field. Gone! And we are tied here in the ninth. A two-run home run for Chase Utley, number 13 for him on the year, and that'll pull him into a tie at 7-7.
Out there on the mound, what on earth just happened?
he was cruising along. He got the first two outs, then on two pitches, single, home run. I tell you, you can't let your guard down for 1 second out there. You're going to get burned.
Don Kelly will start things out here in the 10th, and you have to figure this is not a position that he or anyone else on this team, for that matter, expected to find himself in.
Yeah, they had to figure they were home free, but just a dreadful job of sealing things up in the bottom of the ninth. And now they've got to find some way to put that inning behind them and go to work getting themselves at least a run here.
Donovan Solano will dig in, needing to find a way to get that go-ahead run in from second base. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. And that's in there. Base hit. Around third and being waved on home. And the go-ahead run will score from second as they've taken the lead here in the late going. So a runner at first now with nobody out. And that'll bring in Jared Saltalamacchia. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good. Jeff Mathis will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. And a tough slider there from Harang. No balls and a strike.
Yeah, he needed that one. Something to give him a little bit of confidence.
Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball. Chopper, foul. Now the veteran deals on 1-2. Oh, on the ground is short. Could this be two? There's one. And that didn't work out too well as the pinch hitter comes on to bounce into a double play. Christian Yelich. Dig in with a very important insurance run 90 feet away at third. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. And here's the first pitch. Starts him with a breaking ball this time. Misses down and in for a ball. 1-0. Well, they miss with the first one, but then they decide, let's go ahead and just put him aboard here, and they'll do just that. Martin Prado is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one.
That's not a bad idea right there. Take a pitch. Make sure you get a good look at him and what he's throwing.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. Beltre will put this one away and the side is retired. Marlins get one here on a couple of hits. So now we'll see if these guys can get even in the bottom of inning number 10. The Marlins lead it 8-7. A.J. Ramos. We'll try to wrap things up here and save things in the bottom of the 10th. Michael Franco come forward now, trying to at least get on base with his guys down a run here in extra innings.
Yeah, I don't think you really need to be swinging for the fences just yet. You just need to find a way to get some guys on base and get that conveyor belt rolling.
Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. Oh, and he took a big swing at that one as this is driven out to deep left center field. And this one is gone, a home run. So a solo shot here to left center field. 12 home runs for him now thus far, as that makes this an 8-all ball game.
Second pitch that's coming on, and I guarantee it, he was not looking to put it there. This is right in the wheelhouse, and he just didn't miss that one.
Adrian Beltre will stand in again as we flash you back to the middle innings here. This was a big blow, a two-run home run that really got his guys going. First pitch to him. Now a ball lying towards center field. And Beltre's got himself a base hit.
And when you see a guy rip one like this, one pitch after the previous guy left the yard, you know you're dealing with a pitcher whose mind is elsewhere. That'll snap you back to reality, though, pretty quick.
Aaron Crow will get the assignment on the mound here as he'll enter with the runner at first and nobody out. Aaron Crow. Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as he gets under the first pitch and sends a fly ball out to left center. Yelich able to take this one in, and there's your first out.
You know, once you get into extra innings, every fly ball here makes you go, whoo. But this one didn't have a whole lot behind it, so we're going to keep on playing.
Here's the first pitch. And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul, strike one. Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. And that'll get through into center field for a base hit. Throw comes in quickly, so the winning run advances to second now with only one away. And if you're wondering what's left on the Phillies bench, there you go. We'll see if one of them gets pressed into service here. Freddie Galvis will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. Here's a hard hit ball back up the middle. Solano for one on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Phillies will have to be content with just a one. No winner yet. On to inning number 11 we go. And we are deadlocked at 8 apiece. Genmar Gomez will be summoned from the bullpen here as he'll take over to start inning number 11. Giancarlo Stanton will stand in to lead things off here in, can you believe it, a tie ball game again.
Yeah, this thing has had more ups and downs than my 401k. And I've got a feeling we got some more to come.
And this will find the seats behind the first base dugout. 1-1 on the way. And this is fouled straight back. Now the 1-2. That one misses, and I think a ballpark full of umpires disagrees. It's 2-2.
And think about it, in game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend.
A quick out number one.
Boy, and they've had his number all through this one. He's now 1-for-6 in this ballgame. Man, that hurts.
Here's the first offering. Marcell Ozuna is at the plate as he takes a cold strike one.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times he's going to be taken anyway, and you just bought yourself a strike that you can now throw anything off of.
Jordan is there, two down.
Two quick outs here to start things off. Can't ask for much more than this in extra innings. Hold, serve, then give your guy the shot to win in the bottom half.
Jeff Baker is at the plate now, and he takes a cold strike.
And guys, this has been just what the doctor ordered out of the bullpen.
Yeah, they needed him to come in and give him a strong inning, and he's done exactly that.
And he gets there, as he had a lot of ground to cover that time, and the side is retired. So nothing happening this time around. It's getting late. One run can win it as we move to the bottom of the 11th. And we are deadlocked at 8 apiece. Xavier Paul will step in, a ground out victim his last time. Here's the first offering. Now a ball bounced towards the second baseman. On to first is Baker for the first out. Ben Revere will step in, 1-for-4 in the ballgame. Now here's the first pitch. Here's a swing, and he saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. On to first, and there were two down.
And this is what you're going to get when you've got a hard thrower coming out of the bullpen. When you're late on a fastball and you make contact below your label, it's snap city right there. He turned that bat into firewood.
Chase Utley will stand in yet again, and as he does, we flash you back to inning number 9 as this was the big blow, a two-run shot that helped get us to this point here in the extra frame. First pitch coming. first pitch of the AB is swung on and lifted in the air to straightaway center. Ozuna is there to make the catch, and that means we've got more baseball ahead. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. This remains an 8-all tie. Don Kelly will stand in to start out the 12th inning of play, and it starts to become a war of attrition once you've reached this point in the ballgame.
Yeah, we're getting to the point where there's some really tired legs out there on both sides. The bullpens have been working overtime. Heck, even the announcers are starting to get a little bit hoarse.
Swing and a line drive. Foul. Now here's the pitch. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground to short. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here.
Well, in most cases, once he kicks this thing, it's going to be a sure error. But luckily for him, he's got a diesel tanker headed down the first baseline. So he's able to gather this thing up and still get the out at first.
Donovan Solano is in for a third plate appearance as he watches one miss inside. It's 1-0. Oh, and he comes after him again there. Ball two. Can't imagine guys like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that high.
Foul back. The 2-2. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down.
Wow. Now, neither team really seems to want to take command of this ballgame. I mean, this is right for the picking. The guys are just not coming up with good at-bats right now.
Jared Saltalamacchia is in with two away as he takes a ball, 1-0. 1-0 on the way. Back to the changeup, but this one finds the target for strike one. Now here it comes. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here. The pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. Two out, nobody on. Swung on and hit in the air to left. Paul is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. Nothing across here this half. Still one run can win this thing as we move ahead to the bottom of inning number 12. And we are deadlocked at 8 apiece. Brandon Jordan will lead things off here as they look to try and win this thing in the bottom half. First offering on the way. Swing and a miss on a pitch in the dirt, and it's strike one.
And for as bad as he missed that pitch, you can bet we're going to see that again before this at-bat's over.
Now the pitch. A drive to left. Get out of here. Get out of here. Gone. They win it. Santa Maria. One swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
And this is exactly what you're looking for in extra innings. Actually, it's what you're praying for, really. One big swing sends the folks who stayed here home happy as he wins it with the walk-off homer.
Top's player of the game honors for this one, and guys, I think we can all agree that this fellow right here deserves it more than anybody that took the field in this one.
Yeah, I think in the end this really could have been anybody's award, but what the heck, let's go ahead and give it to this guy. He's as deserving as anybody.
So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click on over to theshownation.com. The Phillies win this one 9-8.